The hope of the Hebrew people for a Messiah echoed through the centuries. God reveals a sign to Isaiah.
Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son and shall call his name Emmanuel.
How will he come? When will he come? Where will he come?
Luke describes his coming this way. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered for the census. All went to their own town to be registered.
Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child.
Micah's words were about to be fulfilled. You, O Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, from you shall come forth one who shall rule Israel.
Will he be born in a king's palace amidst gold and silver?
Will he be born among people with great wealth amidst riches and splendor?
He was born in a stable because there is no room for them at the inn.
Oh, what great joy Isaiah's prophecy is fulfilled, for to us a child is born, to us a son is given.
Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
A child, a child, shivers in the cold.
In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified.
The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord."
And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying,
"Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among people of goodwill."
When the angels had left them and returned to heaven, the shepherds said to one another,
"Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us."
So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph, and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told to them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them.
Isaiah said of old, "Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen up upon you. Nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn. They shall bring gold and frankincense, and shall proclaim the praise of the Lord."
Magi, kings from the east, came riding through the desert sands and over towering mountains.
They saw the star, the same one they had seen in the east, and it went before them until it stopped over the place where the child was.
They went into the house and saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and worshipped him. Then, opening their treasure chest, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Mother and child.
custom of giving gifts on Christmas Day began with the wise men. For centuries, people have followed this practice as an indication of their joy over the Lord's birth and the beginning of our salvation.
We too are called upon to offer gifts to our Lord on the day of his birth. We are called upon to give ourselves to him, to dedicate our hearts to him.
The story of the little drummer boy plainly teaches us how we should give of ourselves to the Lord.
The little drummer boy was playing his drum on a street of Bethlehem on the night that Jesus was born. He sees people carrying gifts and rushing towards the same part of town. He asks,
"Where are you going?"
Someone answers,
"We are going to see the newborn king. Why don't you come along?"
"Come," they told me, "our newborn king to see, our finest gifts we bring, to lay before the king, so to honor him when we come.
The young boy follows the crowd to the stable. He accepts the royal birth without question. He does not ask,
"Why is the king born in the stable?"
The little poor boy wants to give the baby king a gift, together with the others, but he does not have one. He suddenly gets an idea and asks,
"Baby Jesus, I am a poor boy too. I have no gift to bring that's fit to give our king. Shall I play for you on my drum?"
Mary nodded. The ox and lamb kept time.
"I played my drum for him. I played my best for him. Then he smiled at me and my drum."
His gift was from a pure heart. He offered his best. It was accepted and rewarded with a smile.
The little boy's gift is accepted together with those of priceless treasures.
Treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart.
"Truly, my son, the prayer of my troubled heart is now fulfilled with your coming. For here, through faith, is born the Son of God, Emmanuel, the child of hope and peace."
Christ is born. Glorify him.
Christ comes from heaven. Receive him.
Christ is on earth. Praise him.
All the earth, sing to the Lord.
All you people, sing praises in gladness, for he has been glorified.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace on earth to people of goodwill.
Praise to the Lord this holy night.
Praise the Lord.
We thank our wonderful Sunday Church School staff, Helen and Julie, for all you've done. You can see on the list those who helped out. We thank our beautiful cast, our narrators. I think one was cuter than the net. They were all adorable, and we thank God for them. Merry Christmas to you all. Thank you so much for bringing the joy in our hearts as well. You guys did great. You can come, parents can come take a quick picture. We are going to post the pictures on our email blast.
Maybe to make a